Hello everyone, hope you all are fine. So today we already had two classes previous week and today is the third day of third class in the this week. Previously when we used to have the old normal, we used to have three classes every week. So now today we will be discussing the atoms, molecules and ions chapter. So that chapter, as we were discussing certain question answers. Today also we will be discussing certain question answers based on that, and I have given you some homework. So today, based on those homework from the exercise only, I gave the homework. So today we will be discussing those. I gave questions, and that first question, that is question number 6. If you have the copies, you sit. I hope you all are sitting with the copies. The first answer is that question is, the name one ion for each of the valences +1, +2 and +3. Now +1 can be sodium, Na+, magnesium is +2, Mg2+, and aluminium, that is +3, Al3+. Third one is -1, -2 and -3. So fluorine can be example, or chlorine can be example, or better to say fluoride ion and chloride ion, that F- Cl-. -2 can be oxide, O2-, and -3 can be nitride, that is N3-. Next question, the valency of calcium is 2, write the valences of other radical in the following compounds. The first is calcium oxide, so Ca2+, already mentioned here, so oxide valency, just now we have said, the valency will be 2. Do not write -2, again I am repeating, whenever you are writing valency, you must not give the signs. Plus, positive, negative, you should not give. So, valencies of other radicals, calcium oxide, valency is 2. Calcium hydroxide, so valency of hydroxide is 1. Third is calcium carbonate, valency is 2. Calcium chloride, chloride valency is 1. Now, how we are getting it? We are seeing the numbers which are written in the subscript. For calcium oxide, nothing is written in the subscript. That means 2 and 2, they are cancelled. That's why 2. Now, previous day I was talking about that in some cases the subscripts, or we do not cancel the number which are divisible. As for example, hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide has formula H2O2, but we do not cancel and write HO. That's because of their internal bonding. There are certain molecules whose structures are like that, whose bondings inside are like that with other atoms, that we cannot do this cancellation every time. Oxide ion has valency 2, but hydrogen peroxide is actually having an anion called peroxide. Peroxide formula is O2-, and oxide formula is O2-. So there is a difference between peroxide and oxide, and that is why this cancellation is not possible. The formula itself has O2 in it, so that's why we need to write H2O2, and O2's valency is 2, that's why 2. H valency is 1, that's why it is H2O2. Clear? But here, calcium oxide, the oxide has symbol O and calcium has symbol 2, Ca having valency 2, and oxide has symbol O and valency 2, so 2 and 2 is cancelling to form calcium oxide. That's why valency of oxide is 2 here, and hydroxide, that is CaOH, whole 2 is written. That means there is no subscript below Ca, no number is there, so hydroxide valency is 1. Similarly, chloride valency is 1 as it is CaCl2, and carbonate valency is 2 as it is CaCO3. Hope you all are sitting with the homework. Then next question is, write the names of the following compound. Now be very careful about this spelling when you all are writing the name. First is NH4 whole 2 SO4 ammonium sulfate. So there will be double M, AMMO, ammonium sulfate. Then next is CaNO3 whole 2, that is calcium nitrate. Then third is FeS. Now FeS, iron has 2 valences, variable, it is actually having variable valency, it has ferrous and ferric. So you need to either write ferrous sulfide or iron in bracket 2 and then sulfide. 2 means not in the English as we write 2, it is in Roman 2, iron 2 sulfide or ferrous sulfide. Do not write only iron sulfide. Only iron sulfide is a wrong answer. So ferrous sulfide or iron 2 sulfide. Then next is Na3PO4, sodium phosphate. We write ferrous, ferric, cuprous, cupric, or the valence is in the bracket when there is variable valency only. Other cases directly we will write like sodium phosphate. Do not write trisodium phosphate. It is not necessary at all. Na3PO4 sodium phosphate. Then NH4OH, ammonium hydroxide. Then CuCO3. Now see, once again an element with variable valency. So either you write copper 2 carbonate or you can write cupric carbonate here, because copper's 2 valency, 2 is the highest, 1 is lowest. So when it is Cu1, then cuprous. When it is Cu2, then is cupric. So either you will write cupric carbonate or copper 2 carbonate. Then AgO, mercuric oxide or mercury 2 oxide. Then ZnCl2, zinc chloride. Zinc is not having variable valence. Zinc has only one valence, that is 2. So zinc chloride. Then ZnS, zinc sulfide. IDE, check the spelling. Sulfide, IDE, sulfide, ITE, and sulfate, ATE. So sulfate, sulfide, and sulfide. Then is hydrogen sulfide, H2S. Hydrogen sulfide is a gas. Just for your information, I am telling you, H2S is a gas at room temperature and it has a rotten egg smell, and that is why the gas is very popular. If anyone asks you what is the smell of H2S, that is rotten egg smell. Now there is a difference between ammonia and ammonium. Ammonia is a gas, it's a stable compound, it is a formula NH3, and ammonium, it's an ion, it's a radical, it is having formula NH4+. Ammonium ion does not exist independently in nature. It only exists in solution. When there is another anion present, with that anion only, NH4+ can exist. So apart from solution, ammonium ion does not exist anywhere else. But ammonia gas NH3, this exists nicely as gas. It's a stable compound. So whenever you are writing a compound having the radical NH4+, do not write ammonia sulfate. It's not ammonia sulfate, it's ammonium sulfate. At the end, if you have IUM in maximum cases, like sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium, ammonium, these all are having positive charges. So they are positive radical, they are electropositive. But if it is ending with just an A, ammonia, it's a gas. Ammonia is a gas which has pungent odor and it is highly soluble in water. So ammonia NH3, ammonium NH4+, do not do such mistakes once again. And previous day we were discussing about different types of question, like if X and Y is an element and if their valences are given, you need to write the formula. If the formulas are given, you need to write the valences. So some more those type of questions we will be discussing in the next day also. Keep revising this chapter based on the valences and the writing formulas. Keep practicing the writing formulas. From the exercise, I'm giving you the homework. Do not skip doing those homework. I'm discussing the question answers also. Now you have very less syllabus. As we all know, the syllabus is very less. We have only these 3 chapters for our half yearly and we have completed discussion. So we will be discussing different types of question from these chapter. 2 chapters you have given unit test also. You all are very clear with this chapter. Now every day we will be discussing different types of question, and based on those questions we will be discussing the doubts and your queries. And again I am repeating, if you all want me to repeat any part once again, you please write me in the mail that this part I need to discuss once again. So in the next week I will be discussing those particular part once again. It can be based on any part of from these 3 chapters. See you in the next week. Till then, take care and bye.